Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining my lightning talk, Applying Open Educational Resource Content to Create a YouTube Mini Course Playlist. I'm Dr. J. Fulgencio. Welcome. So I've been an instructor for a decade plus now. My majority of my experience is in higher education, so I've taught online, face-to-face, hybrid, and fast-track. I'm an OER scholar. User and a fan of it, and of course I've taught various subjects including entrepreneurship, American federal government, and other subjects as well throughout my tenure in teaching. I am an instructor, as I mentioned, in the Chicago area. So a little overview of my lightning talk about open education practices, getting started on how to create your own open educational practice, and of course tools, and my example of my actual YouTube mini playlist that I created of an open educational textbook on entrepreneurship. So what is open education practices? EDUCAUSE basically defined or has a definition as the use and reuse creation of OER and collaborative practices employing social and participatory technologies for interaction, peer learning, creation and sharing empowerment of learners. And of course, open practices, this briefing paper, open education practices includes the production, management, use and reuse of open educational resources and practices and, using open technologies. And so, of course, what I did with my YouTube playlist is, of course, what exactly I produce, manage, and use and reuse of open educational resources of an OER textbook. And of course, one of the significance for faculty is it helps develop more autonomy by providing tools to help revise and remix. So that's the great thing about open educational practices, is that it gave me the autonomy and the freedom to create a video resource of an open educational resources textbook, this entrepreneurship textbook, because I had experience where, an entrepreneurship textbook that's published by a major company, I had to get permission to use the textbook from the publisher, and then they wanted to charge me a fee for using the resources of an astronomical amount, which I was like, I'm not paying for that. And so that's the wonderful thing about open education resources, especially open educational practices, that I can do that. I can, use the OER resources for the goodwill of learning. And of course, for students, it also gives them control of their learning, because they also can create content for themselves of what the material is. The downside, of course, it's time consuming. When I created this playlist, these videos, it was very time consuming. I had little to no support. I had to do it all on my own, use my own equipment, and there was no financial incentive at all. I didn't have no support as well. So again, this was all done of my goodwill for the good cause of open educational resources and my passion and love for teaching. That's why I did it. And of course, you lose control really when students are involved. And you give them the free reins to do it. So getting started. So in order to get started with this, you have to ask yourself, what's the goal? What's my plan? And what resource do I want to use? Or what source do I want to use to create, whether it's with the YouTube videos or other type of content? Like, what's your goal? Without a goal, then it's going to be difficult to finish the process. Of course, select the textbook in this case, or the resource. I selected a textbook. Draft out a plan and a timeline. You have to, whatever timeline or draft that you want to do a plan, that's up to you. Gather the material that you need, and of course, start creating. So here's my example. So I created an Entrepreneurship 101 video playlist on YouTube. And so I use this textbook, Entrepreneurship and Innovation Toolkit. Of course, this was provided by the Open Textbook Library, which is a phenomenal resource. This book was published in 2017, or available since 2017. I published these videos in 2019, so it still had relevancy. It wasn't like I grabbed an old textbook from 2010, started creating in 2019. I did 8 videos in total. As you can see in the table of contents, there's 10 chapters. However, because I planned, and I read the books, and in my experience in entrepreneurship teaching and entrepreneurship, I was able to, you know, put together some of the chapters. And of course, I came because I looked at the chapters. They were very short, and they two of the chapters are extremely short that I can combine it with another chapter. So, and I'm actually going to show you how to get to the video. So if you go to YouTube and in the search box, you type in Dr. J Real Talk Entrepreneurship 101, you will see at the top of the top of the page. And I am actually going to show you. When you're in YouTube, just type in Dr. J Real Talk Entrepreneurship at the top in the search box. You scroll down. This is another video that I did. You click right here, Entrepreneurship 101 course. You see it's a playlist. You click on that, and you will be able to see, well, this is, of course, an advertisement. So you'll see here, this is a list of courses. And, of course, to date, of all the videos, this is the most viewed one. And so this is, of course, the videos. And, of course, you are more than welcome to use, reuse, or use in your classroom as you see fit. So this is just a playlist that I have. So again, just type in Dr. J Real Talk Entrepreneurship 101 at the top, and it'll be the second link at the top. So that was, of course, again, that was the playlist. So what I had to do when I'm planning out, I had to draft the storyboard from the book chapter. So I, you know, what was I going to say and do for each video? So that's what I did. Create a timeline when I need to get it accomplished. Some of the equipment that you need to gather if you're going to do such thing, and of course it just depends on you. You need some type of microphone, like a good microphone to record your voice. You need some type of really good lighting. I had some LED panel lighting that I had on my own, so I used that. And of course you need a computer. So I know some institutions may provide, you know, this equipment for you for, you know, to rent or to use. Or if you're very fortunate, I know some institutions in the past have actually allowed recording of such videos at the university or the college. But if you don't, this is the type of equipment that you will need. And of course, you will need some type of software like Camtasia or other source open technology to record yourself, to record the computer in case you need to, you know, if you're doing video with recording the lecture slides, which I did. So of course, if you need assistance on how to get started, I'm very open to speaking with you or your institution. You can visit my website, get in contact with me through email. And of course, you can follow me or message me on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram at jphd18. And thank you for listening to my lightning talk.